So what did we learn from the Brazilian Grand Prix? Just how blistering was Verstappen's pace? How far off would Piastri have been without his penalty? And what does the data look like around the Piastri-Leclerc-Antonelli crash? All that and more will be answered shortly with full data analysis of the race. So first of all then, here is your overall race pace, the average lap times of each driver throughout the whole race. And somewhat unsurprisingly, Verstappen was quickest. Yes, he used that extra set of tyres and we'll come back to that in a second, but he did have the fastest overall race pace, nearly half a tenth quicker than Lando Norris, who was the second quickest. And then we have Piastri sat here, just under a tenth slower than Norris overall. Although if we look at the traffic to contextualise that a little bit more, we see that Piastri was sat in traffic for 18 laps, sat behind other cars that is, Norris only 2 laps. So perhaps the pace difference between Norris and Piastri was actually less than that, roughly 1/10 delta. Of course, there was that Piastri penalty, which significantly impacted his race position, but ultimately it wasn't a bad showing for him purely on pace. Looking backwards slightly, then we get to the Mercedes, and actually Antonelli has pretty much fair and square been quicker than Russell throughout qualifying as well, which has been really impressive to see. And we see the tyre strategy very similar between both of them, both one set of softs, 2 sets of medium. Antonelli, again, nearly a tenth quicker than Russell. Very impressive. And then, of course, Behrmann here. So Behrmann about 4/10 off the pace of Max Verstappen overall, although used one less set of tyres. Behrmann's about 2/10 slower than the Mercedes, which is really impressive. I mean, a Haas being so close to the Mercs, and even the McLarens, to be honest, is very impressive. And he drove incredibly well to convert that. Tsunoda then, 0.65 off of Verstappen, which is roughly what we've seen before. It has been up at more like 8/10 at some races, but that's pretty typical. They both did the same number of stops, but it's still, you know, a huge delta for a teammate. And then just coming back to Verstappen briefly, just to comment on his tyre usage. Of course, he had the extra stop compared to Norris, and that was partly just because he had a puncture on that hard tyre at the start. Now, the hard tyre wasn't brilliant, but still, he had to get off it probably earlier than what was desired, and that ultimately meant that his medium soft stint that followed all had to be extended compared to had he have run the hard tire. In fact, had he have run the hard tire longer, maybe he wouldn't have needed the extra stop, or he would have had fresher soft tires at the end. And I think we can all pretty much say that had he have had, you know, even a few laps fresher soft tires at the end, it would have been P2 for him. Now, moving on to the fastest laps of the Grand Prix, these are the 20 quickest laps of the whole event. It's actually Albon in the Williams, using DRS on medium compound tyres, who had the fastest lap, although that was pretty much matched by Verstappen without DRS. The majority of these laps, of course, all at the end of the race, and there's actually a lack of teams in here. We've only got McLaren, Williams, Red Bull, and then a single Alpine lap. No Mercedes laps. They were generally conserving for most of the race, trying to get through on tyres. And I think that did make the race a lot more interesting, that we had these very aggressive strategies and also the more management-based strategies. Also, very few laps from Norris. There's only one here that I can pick out, which just showed he was in a more comfortable race than Piastri. And onto consistency then, we see it's Norris, the most consistent driver of the race. It makes sense. He had a lot of free air, so he had the best means to do that. Then followed by Piastri, another indication that Piastri on pace didn't have a horrendous race. And then the Mercedes guys doing incredibly well. Russell slightly more consistent than Antonelli, in fact. Verstappen up there, but not right at the top like he often has been. Of course, Hamilton here suffering from damage. Albon actually very inconsistent, which is interesting to see. And then Behrmann doing a pretty good job, being within the top sort of 30, 40% of the drivers when it comes to consistency. Then coming back to the laps in traffic, we see Verstappen actually spent 27 laps behind other cars. He had a lot of overtaking to do, and I think that shows that the pace we saw above, him being just less than half a tenth quicker than Norris, quite likely would have been a lot more in free air. And that is possibly why Norris was slightly concerned in his radio message at the end of the race. Yes, he'd won, but on raw pace, I think he knew that they weren't quite there. And then looking at tyre wear, Russell, Verstappen, Piastri and Norris, we see actually Verstappen's tyre wear being pretty high when we look at the summary here, so higher is more wear. If we look at how the laps actually panned out, so these are fuel adjusted lap times, so they aim to show just the change in lap time due to the drop off of the tyres, so a steeper gradient of these lines means more wear. And yes, Verstappen's line is steep, but what I will point you towards is these little dots, so these are the individual lap times, and we just see Verstappen, who was able to put in some incredibly quick lap times at the start of his stint, and we saw that he was rapidly catching up to the people about around him when he came out the pits. It probably didn't do any good for his tyres in the long run, which is perhaps why we saw this steep trend of his tyres then dropping off towards the end of the stint, at least on the mediums. That was two stints of that, I think. But he was able to put in those super rapid times, and that's ultimately what was able to get him into such a good track position. And it was brilliant to see such aggressive strategy, again, versus these McLarens, managing a lot more. And we see that with that, they were able to achieve better wear. The same thing also on the soft tyres. Norris and Piastri did do a good job of keeping them intact, although, again, Verstappen, very quick lap times at the start of the stints. So then while we're talking about tyres, here's your overview of all the strategies of each driver. Where these lines are hashed, it's because the tyre was already used before it went on at the pit stop. So in Norris's case here, at the end of his race, that medium set that he was on was already 9 laps used. So that'll be in qualifying, in practice, sprint shootout, whatever, already had 9 laps on it. So fortunately he had a gap behind him, but without that, might have been a bit more precarious for him. Antonelli also 5 lap old tyres there before they even went on. And that's, of course, the stint where he was defending very hard against Verstappen. Verstappen, of course, did have an extra stop. So this long medium bar is actually two different stints, but they were both new from the beginning. And his soft tyre and hard tyre at the very start was also new. Him possibly benefiting there from being knocked out so early in qualifying, using less tyres. And now for a quick look into that incident where we saw Piastri pretty much ending Leclerc's race via Antonelli. Of course, here on the speed traces, this is the start of lap 6, which is where we had that restart. Of course, we see Leclerc's speed dropping off as he goes to DNF. But interestingly, just looking at the speed traces into turn 1, we see, of course, Piastri, the highest line. He has that overspeed. He's got the best slipstream, best drive. He's reacted well to the restart. So he's, of course, gaining. That's what lets him get alongside. But then he does actually start to slow down before the other guys. And if we look actually at the brake application, he is one of the earliest onto the brakes. Now, this only shows whether the brake is on or off. It doesn't show the exact pressure. He could have been, you know, very lightly on the brakes briefly here and then stepped on it. But there's nothing to say that he pulled a crazy lunge, brake super erratically, I guess. I think it's more a case of under braking control, he locked up. Of course, that harms your deceleration. And then he's gone and hit into Antonelli. So finally then, I'll leave you with the pit stop data. It was actually Kick Sauber who were quickest in the pits on average, actually 8% faster than the grid's average, although the grid's average was slightly skewed by a couple of front wing changes and shenanigans in the pit lane for Tsunoda with his penalty. Overall though, it looks like Verstappen had what would have ordinarily been race-winning pace today. Norris was pretty good. Piastri, honestly not far off, I think, on pure pace. It was a decent weekend for him, and also for Antonelli, a really good drive. And same, of course, we saw for Oliver Bearman, and perhaps Russell was slightly off form. But that's all the data I have for you in this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.